from our friends like Christian Council from Congo that they want to come to Ghana to learn from us the role we play towards national peaceful elections. So we have among us church leaders and Muslim leaders. But then the chairman of the National Electoral Commission of Congo decided that he would join them in the visit to Ghana. Your Excellency, humbly, I want to introduce to you the chairman of the Electoral Commission of Congo, and then allow him to tell his own story why he decided to join the faith-based people to Ghana. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Excellency and your collaborators, I would like to say that we are all humbled to have you welcoming us to your residence, to this office. Me and all the delegation coming all the way from the Democratic Republic of Congo. Well, as you know, we have two Congos, but we are coming from the Democratic Republic of Congo, where we are currently preparing towards the general election at the end of this year. We will have three elections on the same day for the presidential candidates, for the MPs, but also the regional ministers. Well, I would like to say that politically speaking, Congo is a unique country because contrary to Ghana, where we have about 10 political parties, in the DRC we have 603 political parties.
Six hundred and three.
With regards to the presidential elections, we are expecting 30 candidates. The legislative elections, we are for 500 seats, we are expecting 28,000 candidates. And for the regional ministers, where we have 711 seats, we are expecting 32,000 candidates. As we are getting closer to the elections, there is more and more tension in the country. So the faith-based organizations decided to come to Ghana to learn how we can prevent, manage, and also resolve election-based conflicts.
I want to thank you for choosing to come to Ghana so that we share our experiences. I think that that is what we should do as Africans. There's best practice across the continent. Each of us doesn't need to go and reinvent the wheel. I mean, we can learn from each other. There are other things in Congo that you're doing better than us, and we also can come and learn from you.
We have a lot of faith and belief that if Congo is able to get it right and establishes a stable democracy with good political stability, it could become one of the fastest growing economies in Africa. Government is doing something they think would lead to problems. They are vocal enough to come out and tell government, look, what you're doing is wrong. And it's the same with those of us in opposition. If they think that we're not doing the right thing, they are very free to come out and tell us, no, what you're doing is wrong. You know, you better correct it. And therefore, we appreciate the work that the religious organizations do. They meet with the Electoral Commission, they meet with the political parties. When the temperature is becoming too hot, they call all of us and cool us down and let us remember that Ghana will exist even after we, the politicians, have gone. One of the good things that the religious bodies do, and they do it in conjunction with the traditional leaders and civil society organizations, is that before every election, they convene a conference where all the candidates or the leaders of the political parties are called to attend, and all of us sign a peace declaration. We sign a personal declaration to conduct ourselves in a manner that will not disturb the peace. So the communique is read to the public, it is televised nationally, and every leader of every political party is there. Our religious leaders are there, our traditional rulers are there. We invite the diplomatic corps, and once the communique is read, they ask all of us if we agree to the communique. We say yes, and then we append our signatures to it, and they all witness the declaration. After that, it's published in the newspapers that this is what we've agreed to. And so that's an effective means of committing us all to a peaceful process. But however you advocate peace, if the Electoral Commission is not transparent, free, and fair, the likelihood that electoral disputes will occur are very real. And our electoral system has continued to evolve and improve election after election. Every election, we look at what went wrong, we do a post-mortem,
and then we do a correction and improve it. And so every election is better than the previous one. In 1992, we started with metal ballot boxes. Today, we're using translucent ballot boxes. Before, we used to vote, and then we take the ballot boxes to a counting center before we go and count it there. Now, as soon as we vote at the polling station, the count is done in the presence of everybody, and everybody is there with their mobile phones, transmitting the results immediately. The count has been done. At the constituency collation centers, the party have their representatives again. And so while the votes are being collated at the constituency level, they are present and they can make sure that the results are exactly what happened. At the national tallying center, we have party representatives again. And so as the results come from the constituencies, they make sure that those results are the correct results so that they are tallied nationally and then the results are announced. But finally, one of the very important institutions that have helped us is what we call the Inter-Party Advisory Committee, IPAC. It's an advisory committee to the Electoral Commission, and it is constituted of members from all the political parties. And so we use that advisory committee to create a consensus amongst the political stakeholders at every step that the Electoral Commission is taking. And I think that that is one of the instruments that has ensured that we have that degree of faith and trust that our Electoral Commission is getting the job done well. But I want to express appreciation that you came to confer with your colleagues to see how you can be involved in ensuring that the elections in Congo are done organized peacefully. As you said, the relations between Ghana and Congo are historical, and you narrated that history. But aside from that, Congo is probably one of the largest countries on the continent, and potentially could be the richest and wealthiest country on the continent. Democracy and political stability have served Ghana very well. If you look at the progress that Ghana is doing, it's because of the very stable atmosphere we've had since 1992 till date.
We'll make sure that whatever you are giving us as an advice, we are going to produce. Thank you very much. Thank you again.